cupboard for? Seriously. I told you last week, you can't be hanging out in all of my cupboards. Right, well, I'm not quite sure where Josh is yet, but let's stand up and join in with the Action Angels.
While my heart is beating, while my body's breathing, my future's there for you to write. Though today I'm hurting, there's a new day coming, bright and shining like your smile. I won't give up, no, no, I won't give in, no, no, you are the tide on which I rise. I won't back up, no, no, I won't back down, no, no, this is the time for me to rise.
For joining in and worshipping along with us. Now, let's head on over to the chair and see what we're going to be looking at today.
So today we are starting a new mini-series in our big series of God's story. And we've spent the last 3 weeks looking at the Old Testament. We looked at creation, the fall, and Abraham and Sarah. And today we are starting a four-week mini-series within the same themes, but we are now looking at the New Testament. And that means we're going to be looking at Jesus's life and all that he did, or some of the things that he did whilst he was on earth. And so that means we have got a new memory verse. And so well done if you learnt the old one and you have sent it in to me. And I do hope you have enjoyed your prize in the post. But here we have a new one, and it is a little bit shorter, and it's going to come up on the screen next to me. And so it says, this is love. It is not that we loved God, but that he loved us. For God sent his son to pay for our sins with his own blood. 1 John 4 verse 10. And that is from the NLV version. But if you are using a different version, then that's absolutely fine. But I personally really liked this version. And so today we are looking at a quite big event that happened in Jesus's life and that lots of us might have already done ourselves as Christians. Maybe we did it as a baby, or maybe our parents have done it as well. And so we are going to be looking at the thing of baptism today and about passing on the message. And so with that in mind, I think it is time for our silly game. So let's head on over to the kitchen and see what Josh and I get up to today. Okay, so for our silly game today, you will need an egg.
I love eggs.
Now, we don't need a chocolate egg.
No.
We need a chicken egg. Okay. And the idea is that you throw it between ourselves to see how far we can go without the egg dropping. So we'll pass the egg between each other.
Yeah.
And not let it drop.
Okay. Cool.
So let's head outside and see how far we can throw it.
Now these eggs went out of date 2 weeks ago.
That's why we've been keeping.
It's going to be interesting to see what they smell like.
Now it's a bit chilly, so I've got my jumper and we've got our egg. So let's see how well this goes.
We also have our replacement egg, just in case it's required for any mishaps. Look at the egg sitting here, best before 20th of June. As you can see, I won that competition. It doesn't normally happen in this, so I'm very happy about this. But look, same egg. This is U3UK11598. This is the number for this egg. I think it's got a good one. This is a good egg. It's a saying, isn't it? A good egg.
And see how far you can throw and see if you're a better catcher than I am. Well done. I do hope you enjoyed our silly game with us. And I wonder how far you were able to throw your item as well without dropping it. So I wonder, what is baptism? Go ahead and pause this video and have a think about it, or have a discussion in your families as to what is baptism to you. So in our church, St Paul's, we baptise both babies and adults. Maybe you were baptised as a baby, or maybe your parents have been baptised as adults or babies themselves. And if you weren't baptised as a baby, that means that your parents made a promise for you on your behalf, saying that when you grow up, you will be a Christian, that you will grow up in the knowledge of God's love for you. And if you are baptised as an adult or as a teenager, then that means that you make those promises for yourself. But if you're baptised as a baby, you then go later on to confirm those promises, and we then have a confirmation service as well. So we're going to take a look as to what baptism looks like, because it's great fun and it's a really enjoyable service to be at. So here is a video that we made a couple of years back when some of our members at church got baptised. So let's take a look and see if you recognise anybody.
I baptise you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Into the building that we will have many baptism services to come. And so baptism is a promise between you and God, saying that you wish to follow in his footsteps. It's an outward sign of an inward reality. And what I mean by that is that we've already made the decision to follow in Jesus's footsteps, but we're showing everybody else that this is the decision that we've made. It's not just that quiet prayer that we maybe say one Sunday in Kidzone at the end, where we say, Jesus, would you come into my life? Because nobody else has been able to see that you've done that. Your heart might have changed, your attitude might change over time. But by being baptised, then you're showing to everybody else, you're making a public declaration saying that I want to follow in Jesus' footsteps. It says that when we go into the water, it represents being buried with Christ. Our old sinful self is dead. And coming back up out of the water represents being made alive in Christ. When we trust in Jesus, we are freed from sin. While we do still sin this side of eternity, we trust and know that we are forgiven because Christ died for us. So that doesn't mean that when we come out of the water, we never sin again. But it's showing to everybody else that we are going to try our best, we're going to try our hardest to do the right thing for Jesus. And even if we do mess up, Jesus will always forgive us. And so many, many years went by, and Jesus grew up from a boy into a man. His cousin, John the Baptist, was living out in the desert. John was a preacher, and he preached about people's need to turn away from their sin, to repent, and to turn to God. John told people that they needed to be baptized as a symbol of their changed lives. He baptized many, many people in the Jordan River. And that river is still there, and so you can have a look and see where that river is. John also prepared the people for coming to the Messiah, God's chosen people. The Israelites had been waiting for God's chosen one to come. Some of them even thought that John might have been the Messiah. When they asked him if he was the Messiah, John said that the Messiah was so much greater than him, that he was not worthy to be his slave. So the people continued to get ready for the Messiah, for Jesus to come. One day, when John was baptizing people, Jesus himself came to the water to be baptized. Wait a minute, did Jesus need to forgive his own sins? No, you see, because Jesus never sinned. But Jesus wanted people to see his example of following God's will. And so although Jesus didn't need to do baptism so that he could be forgiven, so that he could show everybody else that he'd been forgiven, he was baptized so that we knew that that was how we were to live as Christians. And also, this was the time that Jesus began his ministry. So Jesus' baptism to him was a way of saying that he was ready to follow in God's plan for him. And now I am going to ask Josh to read our Bible passage for us.
Hey guys, today's reading is going to be from Matthew 3, and I need my Bible. Something's going funny here. I think it doesn't work quite as well as when Naomi does it. So, the baptism of Jesus. Then Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John. But John tried to deter him, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me? Jesus replied, let it be so now. It is proper for us to do this to fulfill all righteousness. Then John consented. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, this is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased.
After Jesus was baptized, something amazing happened, as Josh read in that passage. The Holy Spirit came and rested on Jesus in the shape of a dove. Then a voice from heaven said, you are my beloved Son, and I am fully pleased with you. It was God's voice, audibly heard. That must have been such an encouragement to Jesus, to know that his Father was happy with him. Doesn't it make us feel so pleased when our parents say, well done, or I'm so proud of you, I'm so pleased with you. Everything Jesus did was to obey his Father. He obeyed God's will for him. Even when he had to die on the cross, he knew he had to die so that our sins could be forgiven and that we would have eternal life. And so Jesus commands us to be baptized as a symbol of commitment to God. However, that doesn't mean that you can't have the Holy Spirit if you haven't been baptized. Because you do. The moment that you ask Jesus into your life, that's the moment that the Holy Spirit comes into your life to live with you. Baptism, as I've said, is just that outward show. It's that outward sign to let everybody else know that you're following in Jesus's footsteps. And so John the Baptist was a man of God. God used him in a very special way. God used John to get people ready for Jesus to come. John was bold in his preaching. He didn't worry about what people thought about him. And we can learn a lot from John's example. How many times do we want to tell somebody about Jesus? Maybe you want to invite them along to something at church, or maybe even just send them one of our videos. But then we might get that thought in our head that, well, maybe they think we're a bit weird or a bit different. Or I don't want them to think that I'm one of those people. The truth is that people are waiting for someone to share God's love. They all need to hear about God's love for them and sent Jesus to die on the cross for them. If we don't tell them, who will? And so as Christians, that is all of our responsibility. We all have that responsibility to tell other people about God. And it can be really, really scary. But just like John did an amazing job at telling loads of people, we don't always need to tell loads of people. But actually by telling one or two people, we can make a really big difference in their lives. And we can have the assurance that we are doing God's will as well. And so we are going to spend some time praying in our families, or maybe just by yourself. And what I would like you to do is I would like you to make a paper chain with three rings on them. So you'll have a ring in the middle and I want you to write your name on it. So I would write Naomi. And then on two rings either side of it, I want you to write somebody else's name who doesn't know Jesus. Because what then happens is that they then tell two people, and they tell two people, and they tell two people, and all of a sudden your paper chain gets really, really big. Or maybe if you don't want to make a paper chain, maybe you could make a people chain, and you could draw a person holding each other's hands, and as it then concertinas out, and you can see that by you telling one person, they tell the next person, and they tell the next person. So take a couple of minutes in your homes, or just by yourself, and pray for those people that don't know God yet, and ask that God would give you the confidence and the wisdom to talk to them, or maybe even share this video or one of our other videos that we've done in Kidzone. There are so many people that need to hear about God's love, aren't there? And I do hope that you've been able to pray for some of those people in your family. And so we are going to go ahead and pause this video again and have some time to discuss what baptism is, why we need to tell people, and some other questions as well. So go ahead and pause the video and come on back when you're ready. I do hope you had a good discussion in your families. Why don't we stand up and join in with the Action Angels as we continue to worship God together?
Day after day, you never change. Ever the same, there is hope in your name. You are the fire. Let the praises ring, your renown.
everyone for joining in with the Action Angels. I do hope you have had a really great morning with Josh and I, and I hope that you have a really great week. But before we go, if you would like to do any more activities, then in the description below there is a link to a website that has got lots of craft activities all to do with Jesus's baptism. And so have a look there, or have a Google search for some colouring sheets or anything else that you might like to do that represents and can remind us of this story. So I hope you have a really great week, and we'll see you next time. Bye! You are